The sooner you go, the sooner you'll get back, huh? Look, I'm going to be all right. I'm okay. Just get going, huh?
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, God. You get me out of this. I'll never moan about being inside again. Cass, what's wrong?
Hello, gorgeous. How would you like the night of your life? Won't cost you the earth either.
Where are we going? The movies?
Oh, come on, lover. I know some really sexy love games.
I'm a backgammon man myself. See this, sweetheart? It's not my Mickey Mouse Club badge.
Oh, no, you're a cop.
Right. Nobody minds you earning a living, but not outside our front door, huh?
Aren't you going to arrest me?
Soliciting's not a crime.
Sarah! Come, Sarah, open up!
You sick bitch. Watch your mouth, Desmond, or I'll have you on a charge.
Will you do that? I'm sure Mrs. Reynolds would love to know where that doll's come from.
Get out.
Don't you ever go near her again, do you understand me?
I don't take orders from scum like you. Now get out!
Oh. Now don't you ever lay a hand on me again, do you hear me? Not ever. See, Sonia? There's nothing to worry about. Miss Ferguson is a pushover.
Thank you, Desmond. You've given me a new lease of life.
She's going to kill you.
She's going to try.
Why did you do it?
Unfortunately, Sonia, it's us against them. Don't ever forget it.
Yes, Sergeant. Yes, that'll be fine.
Goodbye.
Meg, the police will be here soon to interview Donovan and Mitchell. Would you arrange it, please?
Yes, all right. Any news of the others?
No, nothing. The police think they've been concentrating their search in the wrong area. Apparently their big lead turned out to be nothing but a group of bushwalkers.
Oh, and in the meantime, our lot get further away.
What's the matter with them, Meg?
They must realise they can't get away with it. All they'll get is bigger sentences.
Yes, well, I've just been looking that up. Anything from a week to 6 months.
Oh, I'm hoping it won't be bigger. Don't forget, one of them's got your gun.
Oh, come off it. I only want to go to Sydney, not overseas. Yeah, what time tomorrow? Right, put me on it. The name's Barry. Judith Barry.
Right.
Bugger it. Can't get a plane till tomorrow.
Well, then why Sydney? Go somewhere else.
Look, if I'm going to leave the country, I'm going to need a passport. The only person I know for that's in Sydney.
They're growing bloody trees, you know.
Please, Rib, you can't stay here. Look, if I was on my own, it wouldn't matter, but I've got to think of the baby.
What the hell do you think I'm going to do to him? You've got a bloody short memory, Sarah. If it wasn't for me, you'd have done time in the nick. Look, I'm sorry to keep bringing that up. It's just that I really need help. One night, I'll be out of your way.
Is that all?
Promise. Listen, I'm going to need some new gear. You got something that'll fit me?
Oh, sure. As long as you don't want the latest fashion.
Not yet, I don't. But wait till I get my hands on that duck. I'd almost forgotten. Where is it?
I'll put it in the roof.
How do I get to it?
Oh, the manhole's in Joey's room, but... Oh, no, no, don't wake him!
Forget it.
What are you talking about?
You two reckon I'm gonna nod off, right?
Well, you gotta sleep, Phyllis. I mean, you're not gonna get far if you don't sleep.
I got this and that's all I need, so cut the crap.
Oh, yeah, you're a big, tough prisoner, Skippy, aren't you? You've been watching too many movies, mate.
Look, you're in this up to your neck. I don't know why you don't try and help me.
No, we're not, Phyllis. We just come after you.
Yeah? Well, try telling that to the cops.
Oh, yeah, they're going to listen to us, aren't they? They know one of us have a gun. You know what that means, don't you?
What do you reckon I brought the kid for? They won't shoot.
Will you shut up and keep your voice down? You'll wake her up.
Tough! Oh.
It's okay. I wasn't really asleep, Cass, but she won't make them shoot at me, will she?
Oh, no, love, no. She's all talk, that's all.
That's right, Cheryl. She won't hurt you. After all, she's got a little girl of her own. Isn't that right, Phil? Tell me something. You ever hear from the people that adopted her?
Change the subject, fatso!
You fair dinkum, dude. She really got a little kid.
Yeah, that's right. And she'd just be about Cheryl's age, isn't that right?
She'll be 7 next March. Now shut up!
Well, 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 I never knew that. Why didn't you tell us a bit
of... Shut up!
Gee, I'm glad she's not my mum.
Thought you was breastfeeding it.
Oh, half and half. Makes it easy when I live with my next door neighbour.
Babysitter, eh? Would she sting you for that, or is she one of them do-gooders?
No, she just likes Joey, that's all. Oh, she's a bit of a sticky beak, but that doesn't worry me. Hell, I wouldn't have any kind of social life. She... Oh, I forgot. Barry.
Who's Barry?
My boyfriend. He'll be round here tonight.
Oh, no way. I don't care how you do it. You stop him.
Well, I can't. He'll be at the church hall by now.
Why, is he cleaner or something?
No, it's practice night for the choir. That's where we met. Look, you'll just have to disappear when he gets here, that's all.
I'll be buggered. I'm not leaving the house. That him?
Can't be. It's too early.
Who then?
Who is it?
Police. I'd like to have a word with you. Sorry to bother you, love, but we're checking all the houses in the area.
Why? What's going on?
We've reason to believe one of the Wentworth escapees might be in the vicinity. You haven't noticed anyone acting suspiciously in the neighbourhood, have you?
Well, no, but I've been stuck in the house all day.
I see. Well, I'll leave this card with you. If you should happen to notice anything, give us a call on that number, will you?
Yes, all right.
You all right? You look a bit shaky.
No, it's just I live on my own. Don't like the thought of escaped convicts running around the place, that's all.
Nothing to worry about. We've got the area very well covered. Good night.
Good night. Did you hear that?
Yeah. Gee, I thought they might come in for a minute.
Yeah, well, they might have. And where would that have left Joey and me? Listen, maybe you've got to go.
Hey, relax. Look, this is the safest place for me now. They've checked it off their list. It's clean.
Yeah, but what if
you... forget it. You heard what he said. It's crawling with cops out there. I'm staying.
This must be cold by now. How about I put it back in the oven?
Sorry.
Your dinner. You should eat something.
Oh, yes. Look, thank you. I've gone to a lot of trouble. Thanks.
Well, if I warm it up, will you eat it?
Do you mind if I don't? I really don't think I could.
Of course. Well, is there anything else that I can get you?
Help me, Meg. I'm not falling to pieces or anything, but I'm having trouble. I don't understand what's happened. Yesterday I was part of a family. I know I complained about them a lot, but they were mine. I love them. You gotta complain about them, haven't you? You gotta find some way of talking about them. What am I gonna talk about now? What am I gonna think on the way home from work? You're not going to school tomorrow. They're going to a funeral.
have to walk away from that cemetery and leave them there. What am I gonna do?
Hell, Kev, you're going to lose some teeth one day sneaking on someone like that.
Yeah, I'll have to watch it. Listen, you want to win some dough?
Oh, yeah, how much?
How's 500 sound to you?
What have I got to do for it?
Just find a mate of mine, that's all. Reb Kean.
Hey, she's big news. The cops are going bananas looking for her.
They're not the only ones. Will you want the dough or not?
Oh, yeah, no worries.
Okay. Check these places out. She's got to be at one of them. Then get back to me. Can you handle that?
Of course I can. Geez, what do you reckon I am?
Well, get going. I reckon you're a bloody idiot, if you must know.
Reb? I'm just going to put the milk bottles out. Listen, Reb, don't you think you ought to move into the bedroom? Barry will be here soon.
Sarah, what's the matter with the kid?
Sarah! What the hell do you think you're doing?
I told you I'm putting the milk bottles
out. Get inside and don't leave the bloody door open again.
Oh, don't be so stupid, Reb. I've got to milk the baby.
Your gun seal's wrong, you scream it.
Hey, Kev. Kev, where are you? Oh, come on, Kev. Listen, mate. Kev, I found her. I found her. She was bloody...
Shut up! What are you trying to do?
All right. Listen, mate, I found her.
Where?
First one on the list. Sarah Webster's place.
I knew it. Bloody knew it.
Tell you what, though, she's a bit toey. I reckon she'd shoot through if it wasn't for those coppers.
Cops? What are you talking about?
Oh, they're bloody everywhere. There must have been at least four patrols go past while I was waiting, and I was only there about 20 minutes.
Mongrels.
What are you going to do, Kev?
Shut up. What are you on thinking?
Okay. We go in tomorrow morning. In daylight? You're joking. I know what I'm doing, so can it, okay? Now, has Keith still got his business?
Keith Ferguson?
Yeah, why?
Okay, go back and watch the house, and I'll meet you down the
way. Oh, come off it. What about the cops?
There's a lane going up to the backyard. You watch from there. And I'll meet you down the end of the lane about 8 a.m, all right?
What if she makes a break for it?
Stop her.
Oh, come off it. Look, I'm not going to get...
Listen, do you want money or not?
Of course I do.
You do as your bloody well told. Get going.
I just don't get it. I mean, there's nothing on the radio or the television. For God's sake, what's going on? There's six of them on the loose.
Well, they showed all their photos.
Oh, yeah, but where are they? How close are they? Nothing.
It's obviously a police blackout. You see, one of the first things an escapee looks for is a radio.
Minnie and Bobbie are back.
Where'd you get that from?
Oh, Val Buchanan in D Block. They brought her in to do trade duty in the pound.
The pound? Trying to keep it a secret. Are they all right?
Oh, yeah. But Bobby's a bit crook. Reckon she was pissed.
That'd be right.
Company.
Desmond, Stevens, in your cell. The rest of you get a move on.
Lock up early, Miss Ferguson. Desmond, you have a choice. Your cell or solitary? I'll take the cell. I've heard the pound is full.
Oh, Stevens, I almost forgot. Dr. Wiseman will see you in the morning. Better start working on your mad act now, eh?
Good night, Miss Ferguson. See you in the morning.
Maybe I should make an appointment for you too, Desmond. I mean, you've got to be sick, haven't you? Killing your husband while your daughter watches. That really requires treatment in my book.
It'll happen, Ferguson. Just you and me. It'll happen.
Bitch!
Are you all right, Jude?
Yeah, I'm fine. Just a bit whacked, that's all.
Yeah, you don't look too good.
It's the blood pressure, Cass. I'd be all right if I could fall asleep.
Jeez, it's not dangerous or nothing, is it? I mean, can't I do something?
Yeah, go to sleep, will you?
No way. Hey, Phyllis.
What?
Jude's crook.
So?
So do something.
Oh, forget it. Too busy worrying about herself, and let's face it, you have plenty to worry about.
Who's worrying? We're still free, aren't we?
Really? Well, what are we going to do? We're going to hole up in here for the rest of our lives? I bet the cops are moving in right now.
I'm warning you!
Hey, Jude, look, why don't you try to get a bit of kip, eh? Give the old blood pressure a rest.
Okay. Sweet dreams, Phyllis.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Just thought you'd like to know that they're all settled down, Governor.
Thank you. And solitary?
Oh, can't shut Mitchell up. She's been singing her head off ever since the police left. Any news of the others?
No, not yet.
Are you all right, Governor? You look very tired.
Yes, I am a bit. It's been a long day.
Well, there's no point to it, is there? And they're all going to finish up back here sooner or later.
How's Stevens getting on? Has she settled down yet?
More or less. I don't think that sharing with Desmond's going to do much for her, though.
Oh, why not?
Well, let's look at the facts. Desmond's just committed murder. That's hardly a settling influence on someone like Stevens.
I wouldn't worry about her if I were you. Myra's a very level-headed person.
Level-headed? Governor, I don't want to state the obvious, but I mean, her husband...
I really don't want to talk about it at the moment. The decision's been made, and I happen to think it's the right one.
Yes, of course.
Sorry. I must be more tired than I thought.
Look, why don't you go home, Governor? I'm doing a double shift. I can call you if there's any news.
Yes. Yes, all right, I think I will. Thank you.
Hi.
Hello, love. I wasn't sure if you'd still be up or not.
Oh, nearly was it. How come you're so late?
Well, Cassidy made us clean up the hall when we'd finished.
Oh, fair enough.
Like hell. We didn't dirty it, it was the basketball team. I'll be having something to say at the next committee meeting, don't you worry. How's Joey?
Oh, no, Bess, don't. I just got him settled.
You look, a bit worn out, love. Has Joey been giving you a bad time?
Oh, no, Well, he's just been a bit grisly, that's all. I never thought he'd go to sleep.
Hey, Sarah, you haven't got visitors, have you?
Yes, it's Barry. Sorry, Jude. Didn't mean to wake you up. I've just closed the door.
No, you don't. You told me so much about him, I wouldn't mind seeing him. G'day, Barry. I'm Judith.
Hi.
Oh, real surprise, eh, Baz? Jude landed on my doorstep this afternoon. Didn't even tell me she was coming.
Oh, yeah? Where are you from, Jude?
Adelaide. Sorry about the face. It's my beauty treatment. I have to wear it every night for an hour before I go to bed.
Some of the things you women get up to, eh?
Yeah. Well, I could go a cuppa. How about you two?
Yeah.
What the hell's the matter with him?
It's just next door's dog. He's always waking Joey up.
Yeah, they never take the poor thing for a walk. He's just bored. He'll stop in a minute.
Yeah, well, good watchdog, I suppose.
Settle down, you mutt.
The police gave Mitchell and Donovan a pretty heavy time today. They didn't get anything out of them. Didn't think they would. Colleen? You should be in bed.
Oh, I'll be all right. You go to bed, I'll just finish this.
Do you need a sleeping tablet? I think I've got some somewhere.
Well, they won't stop me dreaming, will they? I keep thinking about tomorrow and I don't want to.
I'll be there.
No. No, please, Meg, I'd rather you didn't go.
Why?
I just want to say goodbye to them, that's all. It's just between Pat and kids and me. Besides, Pat's parents will be there. That's bad enough. You do understand, don't you?
Good. And how you fit it all in, Barry? 9 to 5 sale on insurance. Tuesday, Thursday night, you got the accountancy course. Oh, and Wednesday, Friday, choir practice. When do you two get together?
And you've forgotten Saturday afternoon.
Oh, yeah? What happens then?
Barry, scoutmaster for the local group.
Yeah, we've bought little Joey his first cub uniform already, haven't we, love?
Gosh, cubs, eh? Lucky kid.
That clock's not right, is it, love?
Oh, I think so. Why?
Oh, Battersby's called a sales conference for 8 o'clock in the morning. I better get a move on or Mum will think I've left home.
Righto, love.
It was nice meeting you, Barry. Take it easy on the way home, eh?
Yeah, actually, that's pretty good advice. The police seem to be everywhere tonight. I suppose I'll be okay. I don't drink. Well, will we see you before you leave, Judith?
Yeah, minus the mask, eh?
Yes.
Oh.
Bye. Sorry. Right.
Oh, and he lives with his mum, too.
Oh, shut up, Reb. He loves Joey and I, and that's all that counts, so just shut up!
Better now, doesn't it? Now you wait here. Mum will get you a nice warm bottle.
Bloody rabbit food out there. You could have got some decent stuff in.
Wasn't expecting company.
Well, it's lumpy porridge, I suppose.
Oh, hell, Reb, look at the mess you're making. You could have done that in the kitchen.
What's the diff? Would have made the same mess. Anyway, I want to know who's coming before they get here.
Who is it?
Can't see anyone.
That stupid dog a bug at his own shadow. Look, you're going to leave after you've had your breakfast, aren't you?
No way. Plane doesn't leave till 4. Safer here than cooling my heels at the airport. Look, you're both very aching.
Something at him if you like. That usually shuts him up.
Just shut the bloody kid up. Between the two of them, I'm going stark, stare and bonkers.
Yeah? Well, having you around doesn't do too much for my nerves either.
Hello?
Hey, Phyllis. When you reckon we can go look for some tucker, little Shirley is real hungry.
When I decide we're going.
I've seen the sun come up this morning. I could get us back to the bus real easy.
That's real clever of you, Parker. I suppose you think they're all sitting there waiting for us.
Oh, sorry, Phyllis, I suppose not.
Anyway, if you know where the bus is, you know which way north is. And that's the way we're heading.
Hey? That's straight into the bush. Jude'll never handle that. She's whacked now.
It's too bloody bad. I'm not leaving anyone here to blab to the coppers. I'm gonna go and take a snakes. Anyone that puts their noses out that door will be breathing in gunpowder. I'll get lard belly up and ready to go before I get back.
Please, I won't jump on you.
No, look, I know, love, I know. But you see, Phyllis there's real scared. It's better to do what she says. Makes her feel good. Come on, we'll wake Jude up, eh?
Oh, I'm awake.
Yeah, well, you hear what Phyllis said?
Yes. I just knew she had her brains in her bum.
Feel up to a hike through the bush?
I suppose it's okay as long as we don't have to do any mountain climbing. What do you say, kid? You feel like a little walk in the bush beats sitting around here, huh?
Yeah, I'll probably be able to find us some tucker, too. I was real good at finding grub in the bush when I was a kid.
Come on, let's go. Well, come on!
I think that's everything. You sure there's nothing I can do? And you don't want me at the funeral?
No, thanks, Mick. Everything will be fine.
I understand. Will there be many there?
Well, I hope not. Just close family. Couldn't handle too many people.
Well, I'll be off. You ring me if you need anything at all.
Of course I will. Thanks.
She's gone and got herself lost. I was a fool to let her talk me into it.
Shut up, Phyllis.
Here she comes.
What the hell took you so long? Well, there's not an awful lot around here. Phyllis had to go down the side of a creek, didn't I?
Well, what'd you get?
Here, I did get some fresh water, Jude.
Oh, good on
you,
love.
There you go, darling. I washed that out real nice in the creek. And, look at here.
Oh, strawberries.
Yeah.
Harry Butler has nothing on you.
Come on, give me some. I'm starving. No way, Phyllis. This is for Cheryl and Judy.
What?
They need it more than you, Phyllis. Look at them. They're tuckered out. They've got to keep their strength up. Now, come on, sweetheart. You eat that up. Doesn't look like much, but it tastes real good. I already had some.
Thanks. Are you sure these mushrooms are all right to eat?
Oh, yeah, Jude. You can tell by the way they smell. They're real good. Now, you get them into you.
Mm. I wish Wally could see me now.
Come on, hurry up. We've wasted enough time already.
It's all right. Will you shut up and lay off and Phyllis, your bully?
Listen, Dumbo, you shut your mouth, otherwise I'll spread it across your face for you. I'm giving the orders around here, remember?
Yeah, well, start using your brains. They're not going to get far on empty bellies, are they?
Yeah. All right. Well, just hurry up.
Come on, sweetheart. Come on now. You sit down. That's the girl. Now, eat your straw. There you go.
G'day, Bobby.
That's enough, Fisher. Come along, Mitchell. Breakfast. You all right?
Oh, my head's splitting. It was worth it.
Don't know what this'll do for you, then, Fisher. Oh. No sympathy for you, Mitchell. If you can't stomach it, go hungry.
Hell, I can't stomach it at the best of times.
You can't blame him for taking a bit of time off, Mrs. M.
The others back, Mrs. Morris?
Not here for a chat, Donovan, but an answer to your question, no, they're not. I never thought you'd be all so inconsiderate, especially you and Bryant.
I was rather foolish. I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris.
Not half as sorry as Mrs. Reynolds is going to be if she's forced to resign.
Right, you're going. We're still going to be walking around here in a month.
Yeah, well, we're going as fast as we can. Phyllis, will you shut up? Here you are, love. I saved a couple of mushies for you. They're a bit busted up. They'll taste all right, but...
Gee, thanks, Kaz. I'm real hungry. But what about Jude?
Oh, yeah, Jude, you want some?
No. Give him to Cheryl.
All I want is a hot shower and a comfortable bed.
Yeah, well, you're not going to get neither if you keep stopping every 10 yards. Come on!
Will you give him a go?
Yeah, what are you going to do to me if I don't jump, Phyllis? Shoot me!
You've got 1 minute! Otherwise, I might just take you up on that.
Let's have a look at that box, Phyllis.
Oh, jeez, that's not looking too good. Look at all that red around it. Just where I've been scratching it.
Ooh, you sure there wasn't a red back in that old dunny at the shack? Always a red back in the dunny when I lived in the country. Dead nasty little fellas.
Crap, come on, let's get going.
Oh, Wentworth never looked so good.
Yeah, well, we'll be out of the bush pretty soon, Jude. Phyllis, just in case that is a red back bite, I'd keep that side stiff if I was you. Stop the poison travelling up.
What a load of bull. Yeah, and I've let down the tyres on the car, so she's stuck there, unless she decides to hike it.
You see any cops?
Nah, I reckon they've given up.
Then we better make a move for it before she decides to move out. Right, well now you're going to see some real action, mate. I want you to drive up real cool. Knock on the door, tell Sarah you're an electrician, come to fix something. Go through and unlock the back door for me to get in. You got all that?
Yeah. Well, what's going to happen if Red tells you to get lost, Kev?
She's done that to me once too often. This time I get the money, mate. She owes it to me, and I don't care what I got to do to get it, right?
Yeah, right.
Good. Now, put these overalls on and go play tradesman. I'll see you in 10 minutes, Tim, old buddy.
Yeah, Governor gave me time off to go to the Powell funeral. Gotta get a move on.
But Colleen told me especially she didn't want anyone else but family there.
Yeah, maybe she did, but I feel like it's my fault. I should be there in case she needs something, you know.
Yeah, well, I'm glad you're going. And you wish I hadn't let her talk me out of it.
Oh, I'll see you when I get back.
Yeah, be careful, Rick. The people who left the bomb may be at the funeral. I mean, they'll figure that you'll be there.
Yeah, too public for them. They'll wait till trouble dies down before they try anything else. Well, I'll see you, eh?
See you.
Excuse me, madam. But
tell it to the police. I am not interested in your sob stories. I've heard enough to last me a lifetime.
G'day, Ferguson's electricians. The landlord sent me around. Something to do with the wiring in the laundry?
But I didn't call up about any problems.
Oh, I just do what I'm told to, Mrs. Through here, right?
Looks like the landlord's finally decided to fix up this dump a bit.
This place is busier than bloody Burke Street.
Well, nobody's stopping you from leaving.
Don't worry, I'm going. I'll need your car first, though. You can pick it up at the airport later.
Yeah, take it, just go. The sooner you leave us alone, the better.
God, you've changed, Sarah. Got the keys?
On the fridge.
G'day, Rev. You going somewhere?
Kevin, what are you doing here?
Come to get me money, haven't I?
Yeah, but you come to the wrong place. Don't reckon I'd be stupid enough to stash it here, do you?
Yeah. Now hand it over real nice like and no one will get hurt. But don't take too long about doing it, because my patience is worn real thin.
Oh,
You did it on purpose!
What?
We're back where we started, that's what! Don't try and tell me you didn't know what you were doing!
So we are. Oh, geez, I'm sorry, Phyllis. I could have sworn we was going north.
We're going nowhere now. Me and the kid will get better on our own.
Go, Cheryl. You rotten bludger, Phyllis. I tell you, you're going to lay off that little kid.
What the hell are you doing? You've been cut from everywhere.
Yeah, well, that's too bad, isn't it, Phyllis?
It's all right. I reckon we'll be going home real soon now. But we did pretty good, didn't we, Jude?
Peaches!
All right, lady, hand over your money and no tricks.
The same old tricks you did in high school.
Joy. Oh, you really mucked it up this time.
Oh, no, stop it, for God's sake.
Easy, mate. Easy, you bugger. I'll break her bloody arm off if she doesn't give with the money. You know I will, don't you, Rick?
Leave her alone, you
fool. Keep her away, silly bitch. Stick enough for a double crosser like you, Rick.
Here it is. Thank you, filthy money, and leave us alone.
Watch it. Where'd you put it?
Look, let's just talk this out quietly. She'll see sense.
Bet she will, or I'll beat everyone in this room to a bloody pulp. You hear me, Reb? I'll kill for that money. So you better start talking. Real
quick. Colleen, look, I won't keep you. I know you've got to get back to Patrick's folks. I just wanted to say I didn't realise my being at the funeral would upset you so much. I'm sorry, that wasn't why I was there.
Would you please go, Rick? I'm just collecting some papers for Pat's dad. I don't want to go back there. They're so upset. And I don't know if I'm going to be strong enough to help them. Oh, please, let me be strong enough.
Look, I'll wait. I can take you there. I'll drive you.
I don't want you anywhere near them.
Yeah, well, I can understand that. Grief's very, Colleen, would you please let me help you in some way? I just feel so responsible about it.
Oh, no, no. No, don't you feel responsible. It's not your fault. Just one of those cruel twists of fate.
Now, look, I have been there. I do know what you're going through. Everyone's so nice and kind, thoughtful. No one says the wrong thing. No one pays for what happened. I do know how you feel, Colleen.
Oh, you do you? Listen. You put yourself in my shoes for a minute and see your husband and your kids put onto the ground and then look up and see the bastard that should have been in their places. Then tell me how you feel.
I'm sorry. What can I say?
Oh, yes, you're sorry. Get out.
Look, if I can...
Get out.
Time to go home, ladies.
Now, Constable, we're not doing any harm here.
We've had a complaint from the store owner. Says you're stopping customers entering the premises.
You hear that, girls? We're not wasting our time.
What are you doing this for? We're protesting against the filth that that man is selling in that shop.
It has to be stopped. Pornography degrades women and children.
Yeah? Kids too. Mm. Gee, that's disgusting. Oh, we know our rights. Hey, copper, this is a public place, so piss off. Down with police. Down with dirty pictures. Down with dirty coppers butting in. Down with
you
everything.
You call that a peaceful demonstration, do you? Oh. All right, I want you all to pack up and go home.
Oh, down with police brutality.
Look, love, I don't want to get heavy with you, okay? So go home and cook hubby's dinner like a good girl.
Oh, wouldn't you know? He's going to be a male chauvinist as well. Well, down with male chauvinist pigs. Down with dirty...
That's it. You're coming with me.
Oh, yeah, you're going to charge me, are you?
You bet your boots.
Yeah, well, I'm going to do something to make sure you do.
Don't.
Yeah, well, come on.
Come
on. What are you waiting for?
That's enough.
Thank you. Well, I hope you're satisfied.
Oh, no, we're not, Mrs. Morris. We feel rotten.
Well, I don't think that's going to make up for what you did to Mrs. Reynolds, Parker.
No.
Miss Riley, take Bryant through to the hospital for a checkup. I'll take the others into the showers and then to solitary.
Right, come on, Bryant. Really sorry, Mrs. Morris.
Save your apologies for the governor, Bryant.
Oh, did little Cheryl get home all right?
Yes, she did. No thanks to you. You're getting yourself quite a record, Parker. But I didn't think you'd be adding kidnapping to the list.
Oh, hey, Mrs. Morris, me and Judy had nothing to do with that.
What? Like bloody hell, God, it was their idea.
Oh, you're a rotten liar, Phyllis.
I'm going to take her out of you.
Into the showers.
You are going to be lucky if your tongue don't turn blue.
Shut
don't.
Up,
Phyllis!
Bitch!
Okay, maybe it's time to start on Sarah. Want to hear your mate scream, Rev? That make you talk? You'll tell me where the money is, won't you, love?
I don't know where it is. For God's sake, Rev, tell him where it is.
Somebody shot that bloody kid up.
No!
You killed him. Guess I'm getting out of here.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses. Right.